In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Zotero on your computer. This actually isn't a very technically challenging procedure, but it does require a few separate steps and it's not the most obvious thing in the world to do. The first thing you want to do to install Zotero on your computer is to install Firefox if you haven't already. There are other versions of Zotero that work with Chrome or Safari. Personally, I don't think they're as useful as the one that works in Firefox. So if you haven't installed Firefox already, go ahead and do that first. Firefox is completely free, so there's no kind of charge associated with that. You can also install Zotero for free. There's no charge for Zotero. So once you have installed Firefox, which I have here already, you want to go just to Zotero.org. So I'm just going to type that in here, so Zotero.org. You'll see this giant red button here in the upper right-hand corner of the screen that says Download Now. Obviously, go ahead and click on that giant red button. You'll see now that Zotero just updated to version 3.0 last week. So even if you've downloaded and installed Zotero before, you probably want to go ahead and download the newest version anyway. I have installed it before, but I actually uninstalled it from this computer just to make this demonstration a bit clearer. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to scroll down to the middle of the page here where it says Downloads. And where it says here Zotero for Firefox, I'm going to download this version here, Zotero 3.0.1. So I'm just going to click on this. So Firefox is going to ask me if I want to actually go ahead and do that. I'm going to say allow. So it's going to take this new version of Zotero, this 3.0.1. It's going to install this on my computer. In a few seconds after it does install it, Firefox is going to ask me to restart my browser. That's perfectly okay. It's going to ask you this a few times during the process, so you're always just going to say yes when it asks you that. So now it has downloaded, I'm going to say go ahead and install this into my copy of Firefox. It asked me to restart, so I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. So in a few seconds, Firefox is going to restart. It's going to take me back, hopefully, to the Zotero page. That's what it normally does in a case like this. If you're installing this for the first time, it's also going to ask you, once you get to the Zotero page, to make an account. Go ahead and do that. Again, it's completely free and it's very, very useful. I'm going to talk in class about the benefits of why you want to make that account, but definitely go ahead and do that. And again, I'll talk about that in class next time that you see me in class. So I've now downloaded and installed Zotero. I know that I've done that because you can see now in the bottom right-hand corner of my browser, the word Zotero shows up. That's actually my Zotero library. The second thing I want to do during the installation process is install the plugin for Microsoft Word. And you see it's right here under this category, Word Processor Plugins, so Zotero for Firefox. I'm just going to click here where it says Zotero 2.1/3.0. So this is the only part that gets a little tricky depending on what kind of computer you're using. If you're using Microsoft Word like I am for Windows, it's a one-step process. You're just going to click right here where it says Install the Word for Windows Plugin. If you're using a Mac, it's a two-step process. You have to click here first and install the Python EXT. At that point, after you install this, you're going to have to restart Firefox again. You have to come back to this page again, and then click here where it says Word for Mac plugin. Again, because I'm using a PC, I just have to do it once. I'm just going to click here where it says Word for Windows plugin. So I'm going to click here. Again, Firefox asked me, do I want to allow this to happen? I'm going to let it happen. It takes a few seconds to download here. So once it does download, it's going to ask me to install it. I'm going to say again, install, I'm going to let this happen. It's going to ask me again to restart Zotero, or restart Firefox, I'm going to let it do that, which is fine. So now when Firefox opens up again in just a few seconds, I know that again, here is my Zotero library now installed. So if I click on this, it's going to show me my Zotero library. I happen to have quite a few things in mind. I've been using Zotero for years. Yours, if this is the first time you use it, it should be blank, but at least it should look like this. You should see my library. You should see a couple of folders over here. You should see this entire sort of library box here, and you should see at least one item in your library itself. So the other way you can check to make sure this installed properly, I'm just going to minimize my Firefox window here and just open my copy of Word. If you're using a PC, when you get to this point, when you open your copy of Word, under the add-ins menu, you should see this toolbar right here. This is the actual Zotero toolbar, and again, I'll talk about this in class. If you're using a Mac, when you get to this point, we look at the toolbar, there should be an icon over here that looks sort of like a folded over sheet of paper. It's supposed to be like a scroll. It also looks kind of like an S with two blackened ends. That icon is where the add-ins show up for things like Zotero in Microsoft Word for the Macs. So when you click on that icon, it should open up, and you should see under Tools there should be Zotero there as a tab. If you don't see it there, it might be under the Tools tab in your copy of Word. I will say that it's a little bit trickier for the Mac because of that two-step process, but definitely if you install the Python EXT installer and then the Word toolbar for Zotero, you should see it in your Mac. If you have any problems with the installation, you can definitely email me. You can stop by the library, or you can stop by our computer lab in the library, which is room 1109, and anybody in the library or anybody in the computer lab can certainly help you.